Welcome to Understand the Math. This video is part of a series of videos on linear algebra and its applications and covers section 1.6 on applications of linear systems, specifically network flow and balancing chemical equations. Be sure to check out the link below for free guided notes that you can highlight and fill in as you watch this video. The first application of linear systems that we'll talk about is network flow. Network flow problems focus on finding the best way to move resources through a network made up of points called nodes and paths called edges. The network flow problem that we're going to look at is a traffic flow problem. It involves figuring out the best way to manage the movement of vehicles throughout a network of roads. In a traffic flow problem, the basic assumption is that the total number of vehicles entering a node or intersection, called the flow in, equals the total number of vehicles leaving a node or intersection, called the flow out. So you just need to set the flow in equal to the flow out. Let's walk through this traffic flow example. The network in the figure below shows the traffic flow in vehicles per hour over several one-way streets in downtown State College during a typical early afternoon. State College is a town where Penn State is located. We're asked to write equations that describe the traffic flow and then find the general solution of the resulting linear system. In this network, we have four intersections or nodes where traffic is moving into the intersection and flowing out of the intersection. I've copied this figure onto our next page. I've broken this problem down into four easy-to-follow steps. Our first step is to write the equations that describe the traffic flow. At each intersection, we're going to set the flow in equal to the flow out. At intersection A, there are 300 vehicles entering from the left or west, and 500 vehicles entering from the bottom or south, and that's considered the traffic flow in. We'll write this as 300 plus 500. And the traffic flow in is going to equal the traffic flow out. The traffic flowing out of this intersection are X1 vehicles to the east and X2 vehicles exiting to the north. This gives our right-hand side equal to X1 plus X2. We're going to do the same thing to analyze the other nodes. At node B, we have X2 plus X4 going into the intersection, and then X3 plus 300 leaving the intersection. You might want to stop the video and see if you can write down the equations for intersection C and intersection D. At intersection C, we have 100 going in and then another 400 flowing in. And then exiting, we have X4 plus X5. At intersection D, we have X1 and X5 entering. And then we have 150 plus 450 exiting. Our next step is to rewrite the linear system of equations with our variables on the left and our constants on the right. Our first equation is going to be x1 plus x2, and then we're going to leave space for the other variables in our other equations, and then our right-hand side is going to be 800. Our second equation is going to be x2 minus x3, pulling that from the right-hand side, plus x4 is all equal to 300. Our third equation from intersection C is minus x4 minus x5, well, pulling those over from the right, is equal to 500. And then our last equation is x1 plus x5 is equal to 150 plus 450, which is 600. We'll now put the linear system of equations into an augmented matrix and put it in reduced echelon form. Our augmented matrix looks like this. The second part of this step is to go through the row reduction algorithm and put this augmented matrix into reduced echelon form. I went ahead and did that and wrote the answer right down here. The last step is to find the general solution of the linear system. I've already recopied our reduced echelon matrix from our previous page. Let's now circle our pivots. Those are the variables that we're going to be solving for. Our first row gives us x1 plus x5 is 600. Our second row gives us x2 minus x5 is 200. Our third row gives us x3 is equal to 400. And then our fourth row gives us x4 plus x5 is equal to 500. We're going to solve for our pivot variables. Our general solution is then x1 is equal to 600 minus x5, x2 is equal to 200 plus x5, x3 is equal to 400, and then x4 is equal to 500 minus x5, and then lastly, we write down that x5 is our free variable. Values can then be substituted in for x5 to analyze the traffic at all four intersections. The second application of linear systems that we'll talk about is balancing chemical equations. Balancing chemical equations is the process of ensuring that a chemical reaction adheres to the law of conservation of mass. This law states that in a chemical reaction, the total mass of the reactants must equal the total mass of the products. This means that the number of atoms for each element must be the same on both sides of the equation. The example chemical equation that we'll look at is when aluminum oxide and carbon react to form aluminum and carbon dioxide. We'll balance this chemical equation by finding values for x1, x2, x3, and x4. I've broken this process down into four easy-to-follow steps. The first step is to find a vector representation for each term in the equation. To find our vector representation, we first need to identify the chemical elements. Al is aluminum. O is oxygen. And then C is carbon. Now we'll create a vector with these elements. We'll let our vector be vector V, and the first component in our vector is aluminum, and then oxygen, and then carbon. Our second step is to represent the reaction using a homogeneous vector equation. To do this, we're going to be referring back to this equation above. We have x1 times our aluminum oxide. Aluminum oxide has two aluminums, so that first component is 2, it has 3 oxygen, and then it has no carbon, so our third component is a 0. And then we have x2 times carbon, and that's going to be 0, 0, 1. And then that is going to have to equal the aluminum and carbon dioxide on the right-hand side. This is equal to x3. Times our aluminum, which is going to be a 1, 0, 0, plus our x4, times our carbon dioxide, which is no parts aluminum, two parts oxygen, and one part carbon. To make this a homogeneous vector equation, we're going to put all the terms on the left-hand side. This gives us x1 times 230 plus x2 times 001 minus x3, bringing it over from the right-hand side, 100 minus x4 times 021. And that is going to equal the zero vector on the right-hand side. The next step is that we're going to solve the system. We'll start by putting the vector equation that we came up with on the previous page into an augmented matrix. That matrix looks like this. And we have 0 on our right-hand side. We're now going to take this matrix and we're going to put it in reduced echelon form. I'm going to skip those steps and just write down what we get. And we again have 0 on our right-hand side. Let's circle our pivots, and then we can solve for those pivot variables. Our first row gives us x1 is equal to 2/3 x4. Our second row gives us x2 is equal to x4. Our third row gives us x3 is equal to 4/3 x4. And then we'll write down that x4 is our free variable. Our last step is to choose a value for the parameter that balances the chemical equation and then write the chemical equation. Our parameter is x4, and we're going to choose a value for x4 that makes x1, x2, and x3 whole numbers because we can't have a fraction of a chemical element. Let's notice that we have 2/3 and 4/3 in our answers for x1 and x3. This means that the best choice of x4 is going to be equal to 3 because it's going to get rid of those fractions. So let's set x4 equal to 3, and then that gives us x1 is equal to 2, x2 is equal to 3, and then x3 is equal to 4. Our original equation was x1 times our aluminum oxide plus x2 times our carbon, and that was equal to x3 times our aluminum plus x4 times our carbon dioxide. Our balanced chemical equation is then going to be 3Al2O3 plus 2 carbon, and that's going to equal 3 aluminum plus 4 carbon dioxide. Be sure to check out the next video in this series where we'll learn all about the solution sets of linear systems and how to write them in parametric vector form. If this video has been helpful to you, please consider subscribing to my channel. Keep believing in yourself and have a great rest of your day.